Welcome to CRE Fast 5 and today's discussion on what to do with your net lease property during your hold period. I'm Carly Iacono. So you weathered a hectic 1031 exchange or diversified from the stock market successfully and you have your prized net lease property. Congratulations! Although this asset class is often called mailbox money, it is in fact still real estate and does require some thought during your hold period. Today, we're going to talk about communication with your tenant, monitoring the market fundamentals, ongoing tax planning, and your exit strategy. Let's go. Tenant communication should start right after you purchase the property. A letter notifying the tenant of the change in ownership likely went out in connection with your closing already. However, it's wise to make more personal contact as soon as possible. Endeavor to understand the depth and structure of your tenant's real estate department. Is it one person who wears many hats, or are there different contacts for things like maintenance, lease administration, and accounting? If your lease allows for tenant sales and financial reporting, be sure to request as applicable. Now, the tenant may not automatically provide this information even if it's outlined in the lease. So get clear on what information you will be privy to and who to contact under what timeline. Second, pay attention to the real estate fundamentals because they can change. Is the population density in your market increasing or decreasing? Have competitive properties sprung up nearby? Are there a lot of new developments and bustling storefronts in the area, or are the vacancies in the market ticking higher? Now, much of this information is publicly available, but to save time, reach out to a credible broker to review the real estate fundamentals along with market factors such as interest rates, investor demand, cap rates, etc., at least once a year to evaluate your market positioning, both from a valuation and from a real estate fundamental perspective. Third, stay on top of your tax strategy. Most real estate uses straight-line depreciation, but you may benefit from a cost segregation analysis that would allow for accelerated or bonus depreciation. It's routine to have a cost segregation study done when you purchase a new building, but many investors don't realize it can also be performed on a building owned for many years. New deductions can be taken back to 1987 without amending your tax returns. A cost segregation study is also advantageous when you finish construction on a new building or complete a redevelopment or renovation of an existing building. Reach out to your accountant to reevaluate your overall real estate tax strategy annually. Finally, do not overlook your exit strategy. Even if you plan to hold to the end of the tenant's base term and beyond, you need to know what you'll do if they don't renew the lease. If you expect to sell before the end of the base term expires to avoid any rollover risk, consider selling right after a rent increase to maximize the value. Also, be sure to sell when your property is still financeable. Standard bank loans are 5, 7, and 10-year terms, and the loan term will not typically extend beyond the remaining lease term. So if you try to sell with only 3 years left on your tenant's lease, it will be much harder for the new buyer to obtain financing, which will impact your sales price. Finally, in regards to exit strategy, make sure you understand the 1031 exchange process before listing your property for sale and have realistic expectations about what you'll be able to purchase. Holding real estate is an active decision, and it's the perfect time to reach out to advisors like myself for guidance. That was CRE Fast 5. I'm Carly Iacono. I'll see you soon.